Dear brothers and sisters, we're still continuing to talk about shaitan and his ways in leading people astray. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from the evil of shaitan and of the evil of our own selves. Because shaitan normally gets his power, he's empowered over us because of the weakness of our own self. This is why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, frequently in his khutbah, he would say, وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ تَعَالَى مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنفُسِنَا وَمِنْ سَيِّئَاتِ أَعْمَالِنَا. We seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil of our own self and the evil of our own deeds, because one of the punishments of the deeds is that it is followed by another, but one of the punishments of the evil deed is that it is followed by another evil deed. It's a punishment. Evil deeds don't harm Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it only harms us. So it's easy for Allah to punish us for our evil deeds by making us commit another evil deed, because that's what we deserve. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from the evil of our own self and the evil of our own deeds, and of course from the evil of shaitan. And that's basically in every isti'adha, a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan rajim. We say this repeatedly, and especially before we recite the Quran. And even in the salah, we have to remember to do this in every rak'ah before you start recitation of the Fatiha. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. It is a commandment from Allah. فَإِذَا قَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنَ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. Because shaitan, one of his ways as well, and I talked about other ways in the first khutbah in Arabic, but another one of his ways I didn't mention in Arabic khutbah, is that he makes us confused and he affects our understanding, the pure and clear understanding of the wahy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the revelation of Allah. So the ayah is quite clear, but still you misunderstand it. Or you think it's talking about somebody else. An ayah is talking about a sin that you are committing or a deficiency that's in you, but you look to the person standing next to you in salah, or he's the one who's doing that. Although it's talking about us, about ourselves, but we don't think that way. Now, for instance, you find an ayah talking about a deficiency or a sin other nations committed, and we think it only applies to them. مثل الذين حملوا التوراة ثم لم يحملوها كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفارا. Allah talks about those people giving the Torah, that Allah gave it to them, but they never acted, they never applied it, they never followed it. Allah described them كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفارا, just like a donkey carrying books on his back. Subhanallah. The ayah comes to us, oh, you're thinking about people who are giving the Torah. But basically each one of us gets a portion of this yani evil description and severe criticism, because each one of us has many, many ayat and many, many ahadith that we know and we don't apply. So we have to know that shaitan also tries to affect our clear and direct understanding of the Quran and the Sunnah. A hadith comes to you, and then you say, no, it's only a Sunnah, although it's quite clear, it's the saying of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this is the way of salvation and so on, but still you belittle what is being said because, oh, you say it's a Sunnah. So things like this, and this is mentioned also in the Quran, Allah talked about this. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ وَلَا نَبِيٍّ إِلَّا إِذَا تَمَنَّ أَلْقَى الشَّيْطَانُ فِي أُمْنِيَتِهِ. Means that every prophet and every messenger, and of course everybody who delivers the message of the prophet and the messenger till the day of judgment, whenever he recites, tamanna means recited, qara'a, tamanna bima'na qara'a. Whenever he recites the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger, alqa shaytanu fi umniyati, the shaytan tries to distort the meaning, because he cannot distort the wording is preserved, he cannot affect that or manipulate that in any way. So how does he manipulate it? In how we understand it. And you find the trend nowadays that people want to understand the Quran and the Sunnah in a different way. In a way that allows them to be free and do whatever they want. And allows them to set themselves free from all the restrictions our previous righteous predecessors applied to themselves based on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded them and what He has prohibited on them. It was quite clear. And they followed that according to the understanding of the Prophet ﷺ and the Sahaba. But then you find people today saying, no, we have to reinterpret all this and start all over again so that it goes with the modern life that we are living today. Subhanallah. They want us basically ننسلخ من الدين, which means to forsake the religion altogether, but they don't want to tell it directly, but they say, okay, we're going to misinterpret this hadith in such and such a way. There's only one way of understanding the Quran and Sunnah. It is the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was pleased with, and it is the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدْ اِهْتَدَوْا. Allah is talking to the people in general. If they believe in what I have revealed in the same manner, in the same way that you have believed, then they are guided. Beyond this, there's no guidance. And this is why also repeatedly in the khutbah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what would he say? إِنَّ أَصْدَقَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ أَوْ كَلَامُ اللَّهِ وَخَيْرَ الْهَدْيِ هَدْيُ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَشَرَ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا. The best of speech is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best of guidance is the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the most evil of ways is what is innovated in religion. He's talking about religion here. So whatever new way of understanding the religion or any kind of new practice the people try to invent in the recent days or after the generation of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his followers, this is the generation that was pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and their way is the only way that was pleasing to Allah. Any other way would go against that. اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. This is the day I have completed religion, I have perfected your religion, and completed and perfected my favor upon you. ورضيت, and I'm pleased with Islam. This is at the end of the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. يوم عرفة. This ayah was revealed in the last Hajjah. Basically days before the passing of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is why scholars say فَمَا لَمْ يَكُنْ يَوْمَ إِذٍ دِينًا فَلَنْ يَكُونَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ دِينًا. Whatever is not religion at that time, is not considered as part of religion at that time, can never be part of the religion afterwards. So if somebody invents any way afterwards on how we understand the Quran and Hadith and how we follow it, basically, it has to be totally rejected. مَنْ أَحْدَثَ فِي أَمْرِنَ هَذَا مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ فَهُوَ رَدْ. Whatever you invent in this matter of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ, what is not part of it. So look at this, what is not, مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ. Because you can extract from the hadith and the ayat other understanding, conclusions, but from the hadith and ayat. But if you invent something totally unrelated to the hadith and ayat and you want us to take it as a religion, فَهُوَ رَدْ. وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ خَاشِعَةٌ عَامِلَةٌ نَاصِبَةٌ. Allah talks about those people who work hard in this life but not on the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger. He says, وُجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ خَاشِعَةٌ. On the Day of Judgment, they are so frightened because all their deeds are gone and they know their destiny to the fire of hell. But what did He say about them? عَامِلَةٌ نَاصِبَةٌ. In this life, they were working very hard. They were sweating, they were reading, they were praying, they were doing things, but in the wrong way. This is something so important because it is very easy today to follow a sect that deviated out of Islam because they call themselves Muslims or they have Muslim names or they use ayat or they use ahadith. Subhanallah, this is one of our biggest problems nowadays, that people, yani you find, subhanallah, masajid, they say, okay, masjid, this masjid, we want our imam to be a woman. It's not allowed in Islam for the imam to be a woman. It's not. You're praying behind a woman imam. Also, we want our masjid that a man and a woman standing in the same line. You find a man here, then next to it a woman, then next to it a man, then two women, and so on. What is this? Subhanallah. Now some people are coming up with masajid. They say, for gays, a gay masjid. Haven't you heard about these things? Subhanallah, every day we hear something new. Subhanallah. So we have to know that our religion is the religion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and how he applied it. فعليك إنه من يعش منكم بعدي. I'm sorry, I deviated from the khutbah. إنه من يعش منكم بعدي فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا. Whoever lives after me, he will see lots of deviation away from the original path. فسيرى اختلافا كثيرا. So what do we do? He says, فعليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين من بعدي. Hold tight to my sunnah and the sunnah of the خلفاء الراشدين, the righteous predecessors, the successors of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali. Their generations was the generation of application of the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the right way. فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّتِي وَسُنَّةِ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَهْدِينَ بَعْدِي عَضُّوا عَلَيْهَا بِالنَّوَاجِذِ. Hold tight onto it. He says, even with your teeth. Imagine somebody holding tight onto a rope, and then he feels things are slipping off out of his hand. He has to hold onto it, even with his teeth. What is this? It shows you that the current is so strong. It is so easy nowadays for somebody to be fond of a different way than the way of the Quran and Sunnah. And this is why, subhanAllah, if one of us dies on the Quran and Sunnah, he should be happy. This is the only salvation. Because nowadays, many people claim to be on the Quran and Sunnah and they are totally far away. عَضُّ عَلَيْهَا بِالنَّوَاجِذِ وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَمُحْدَثَاتِ الْأُمُورِ فَإِنَّ كُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. And avoid any new ways, invented ways in religion. فَإِنَّ كُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. Inshallah, we'll have to stop here. Inshallah, we'll continue about the same topic, the topic of shaitan, next time, bi-iznillah.